सो लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट द परमिशन. ओके, सो व्हाट इज द परमिशन इन लिनक्स एंड व्हाट इज द स्ट्रक्चर, परमिशन स्ट्रक्चर एंड द करंट परमिशन ऑफ अ डायरेक्टरी, हाउ टू चेंज ओनरशिप एंड हाउ टू सेट द परमिशन. सो लेट्स सी, इफ आई डू एलएल हेयर, दैट मीन्स लिस्टिंग ऑल फाइल्स हेयर. So let's go into the directory cd root. Sorry, let's go on to the desktop directory Ubuntu and the desktop. ls once again clear ll. So I have these permission on my desktop directory and I have these permission on my Akshay file. This is for the RT file and this is for the bin folder, this is for the .ca folder, and this is for the my tar file, my tgz file and wget file. So how can you elaborate this? Okay, let me draw some. So first lines d shows the this is a directory. Okay, and these three things for the
users.
Things for the user group user, sorry, for the file user. Okay, and this is for the group use group, and these three for the other.
Yes.
Okay, so D means
directory.
That's, yes, can say. So I write here and here and here. Okay, so D means the directory. D equal directory. Okay, and RWX. So RWX, it stands for a number. Okay, so I write here R equal to
read
and read number is 4. Okay, and second is W is for write and the number is 2. And the third one is X for the execute the number is 1. Okay, so four to one. Okay, so what is the permission for the user? You can see RWX means the permission is 7. We can sum of these. So there is R is available, that means 4 is added. W is available, that means 2 is added. And X is available, that means 7. 4 to 1 equal to 7. 7 denotes the full permission. Okay. Full permission. Full permission equal to 7. Okay. And here the user permission is 7. And for the group user, group owner permission is R and X.
Right.
R and X, that means the permission is 5. 4 minus, sorry, 4 plus 1. 4 and 1 equal to 5. And for the other is?
Same five.
Good. And for the this file is, total permission of this file is 755.
Yeah.
755. Good. And for this is the total permission of for Akshay file is
644.
RW, that means 4
six,
plus
six two, double four.
644. Okay. 644. Is it clear?
Yes. Fine. This and all fine. No issues.
Okay. And for... Okay. Now all are same. Okay. So you better understand how can 755, how can 644. Right?
Yeah.
Okay. So how to change permission? The question is that how to change permission. Okay. So let's save this and cross. So let's clear this. So let's run some commands about the permission. Okay. If I want to give that anyone can read and write this file, so the command is that chmod. Okay. And u for the user, that means all user, u and rwx, that means the user, Ubuntu user, is only read and write and execute. Okay. And the file name is rt.txt. So this will add the execute permission in rt file. Okay. Only execute permission for only for the user, not for the other user, but only for the user. Okay. So hit enter. Let's check once again ll. That means in rt we have execute permission is here, and green sign, that means we have full access on this directory. We have full access on this file or on this directory. Okay. So star means, that means select all. Okay. And if I want to give the for group permission, group read, write and execute. Okay. Same, so G. Let's same
mode,
G mode.
G plus.
If I want to add R and I want to add only W and X, because R is already available.
Yes.
And I want to add write and execute. Okay. So it will add the group permission, and the file name is rt.txt. Hit enter. Let's check once again ll. So you can see the permission is set for also the group, and we can also set with the number chmod
777.
Chmod. Oh, give me a minute. So we can also add with the number chmod. And the permission, I want to set it for the 777. 7 means for the user, and again 7 for the group, and again 7 for the other user. Yes. Okay, that means the file is, after executing this command, the file is publicly executed. Okay, so the file name is rt.txt. And let's check once again ll. That means RWX, all anyone can read, write and execute this file. Okay. And if I want to remove this permission, so I can run that only user can do the anything on this file. So 700 ll, that means no permission for the group owner, and also no permission for the other user. Okay. And we can also use if there is a directory with any, like I'm going back once and do ll. I have multiple directory. If I want to do publicly this directory or the this directory, so I can run chmod -r for the recursive, and 777 for the publicly access and the directory name. Sorry, cannot access.
Capital R.
Okay, okay, capital R. So now let's check once again. So this highlighted within the green color, and that means anyone can read, write, and execute this. So you understand better the concept is how can 7777755, is there any doubt for the numbering?
Yeah, this and all I know. No issues.
Okay.